Inside your mommy's ovaries, an egg cell was created in a process called meiosis, where her genes were separated to make a gamete cell with only half a DNA. Your daddy's testes made a sperm exactly the same way. It fertilized her egg, then nuclei were fused. 46 new chromosomes, a whole genome to make you. Chromosomes are made from stuff that's known as DNA. Phosphates and sugars linking up in a double helix chain. The chains are joined by bases C to G and T to A that allow the chains to split and then exactly replicate. Mitosis splits the copies into two cells that are new. That's how the cell your folks made the trillion cells in you. When your mummy and your daddy shed their genes,
sexual
genetic variation within the species gave your species the best chance to pass its genes to the next generation. Oh, through sexual reproduction. With a code that can be read by a molecule that tells a ribosome to string a thread of linked amino acids in a folded protein chain that could be hormones, hair, or help control transmitters in our brains. Another DNA switches genes on, and some just does not do much. That's how your unique DNA became a truly unique you. When your mommy and your daddy shed their genes, it made a stem cell and made specialized cells and made you and your proteins. Gave your body a chance to pass its genes to the next generation. Sexual reproduction. Now and then mistakes are made when DNA's replicating, but most mutations won't be seen. Some of them may cause disease, and some cause innovation that may well help you pass your genes. So if you're looking for someone to share your genes, make sure you pick a person with the traits that you would like to see in your offspring, so that they can pass your genes to the next generation. Oh.